Good evening. It was like a firestorm raging in our city. An inferno tearing through four properties in Brisbane's inner south early this morning, reducing two to rubble.
The suspicious, destructive blaze is the second to strike the suburb in as many days.
Glass shattering. Sparks flying from power lines as flames and smoke swirl all around. It's like a firestorm struck this Woolloongabba street. By all accounts, it felt like it too.
When I came out the first time and walked up and was just like, what is going on? I was like, oh, this is hot. This is real.
A home on Heeslop Street catching a light before three this morning. And in this inner Brisbane suburb where houses are packed close together, many of them old Queenslanders, a blaze can be catastrophic. This inferno quickly destroying another property, badly damaging two others, though it's unclear at this stage exactly where the fire started.
There was, probably in excess of 10, 15 residences that needed to be evacuated.
It's understood one of the properties was vacant, more than 100 years old, in one Brisbane family for generations. Now it's reduced to rubble.
The fire here is so intense, producing so much heat, it's melted bins sitting on the other side of the road.
Fast moving and all consuming, but this blaze thankfully hasn't claimed any lives. Everyone made it out, but neighbours had to stay inside their houses for hours as firefighters set up an exclusion zone, closing down streets to commuters, fighting to contain the inferno and save nearby homes.
Given that all the houses in the street are made of wood and they're very close together, this is a fire that could have spread very quickly to a lot more houses.
It had moved so quickly from the first house to three houses that I thought my house was going. Luckily, they saved our house.
It's the second house fire to strike this suburb in as many days, an abandoned property going up in smoke just yesterday. Police say there's nothing connecting the two blazes.
Reporter Lily Greer joins us live now from the scene. Lily, are there any clues as to what sparked the inferno?
Not yet, Melissa. We understand it was actually quite difficult for fire investigators to get on with the job this afternoon. This fire was so intense that even once it was extinguished, it left the ground here hot for hours, too hot for personnel to move in. But what we have seen here this afternoon is fire investigators on scene. They're going to begin the very difficult task soon of trying to piece together what started this blaze. That could take some time. As we go to air tonight, there is quite a bit of action on this street. There are plenty of vehicles around. There are Energex workers working to repair those damaged power lines. And this street, Andrew, it is still blocked off to the public tonight.
Yeah, it was roaring, wasn't it? Lily, thank you.